Hi guys, Alexa Asimos here, and welcome to Real Life Psych. You're watching another episode of Not So Scary Sundays, here to give you your weekly Sunday pep talk from the perspective of a therapist. Today, we're talking about stress. Often, when people face a new and stressful situation, like a board exam that may determine our career, an unexpected car breakdown, or The Office being removed from Netflix and added to Peacock, over time, we start to become stress warriors, essentially developing high levels of chronic stress that seem that it will never come down. Stress can be good in the acute setting to activate our fight or flight responses, but in the chronic setting, it can be a source of mental illness and reduce our immune systems. The question is, what can we do to reduce our daily stress levels? The good news is that there are things that can be done to mitigate the stress of virtually any situation, even if the situation is there to stay for a while. If you are facing a new hurdle, a challenging life situation, or just wondering if it gets any easier and how to speed up the process, I made a list of 10 things we can do to reduce chronic stress. Number one, change in perspective. We can't always control what we are facing, but we do have a choice in how we face it. We can choose the attitude we take and whether we face each challenge as a threat or as a challenge. Research shows that viewing something as a challenge helps you to mobilize your resources and bring your A game to the situation more easily, while the viewing the same situation as a threat can lead to a greater tendency to feel stressed and shut down. If you read about avoidant coping, you can see some of the problems that are associated with shutting down or avoiding your stressor. Your attitude can help to determine how stressful a situation feels for you and how you approach your options. In fact, attitude can affect which options you see and don't see, which can also affect your stress levels and the outcome of your actions. Number two, examine your thought patterns. Your thought patterns may feel automatic, but you can choose where your focus lies. To begin to make that choice, it helps to become more aware of your habitual thinking patterns. This exercise can help you see the patterns more clearly and can help you relieve stress in the process. Number three, practice positive self-talk. Positive self-talk means using more optimistic language in your head and focusing more on possibilities. It involves more than merely trying to look on the bright side, although that's part of it. You learn the specific areas where you can shift your focus and in the process alter what is possible for you and how stressful or stress-free your life feels. So for example, if I notice that I go through life saying, "Oh, I can't do it, I can't do it," I would change that thought process to, "You can do it, you're gonna get through it." Number four, try solution-focused coping. Solution-focused coping means taking action to change your life where you're able to. Sometimes there are certain aspects of a situation you can change, even if you cannot change the situation as a whole. For example, you may, for financial reasons, be unable to quit a job that you don't enjoy, but you can connect with coworkers more, alter your attitude when you're at work, and use your break times for stress management activities, all of which can alter how you feel when you're at your job. Understanding that you can only control what you can control will help remove the self-blame from the situation. Number five, find and eliminate tolerations. Tolerations are those nagging stressors in your lifestyle that you put up with almost without even realizing it, but which bring you constant low-grade stress. The thing about tolerations is that they add up to become bigger stressors. Cutting out tolerations can bring stress relief so you can tolerate more of the things that you can't change. Number six, create a new life plan. Knowing where you want to go, having a plan for the future, can help to minimize the stress in the present. Planning changes according to your values and priorities can be helpful and inspiring, even if you can't bring those plans to fruition for a little while longer. Number seven, self-care. When we're tired, hungry, and run down, everything feels more stressful, and we have fewer coping resources at our disposal. We tend to react to stress rather than respond to it. We let things snowball. Focus on taking care of your body, and you will have a greater ability to handle frustration and stress in your life overall. Number eight, exercise. Speaking of taking care of your body, exercise is one of those wonderful stress relievers that can help build resilience by allowing you to blow off steam. Better still, regular exercise can help you to become less reactive towards stress. Because of that and the obvious health benefits of exercise, this is a powerhouse of a stress reliever that should be worked into your schedule when at all possible. Number 9, positive attitude. Maintaining a positive attitude is one thing you can do to make everything in your life feel easier. A positive attitude also helps you to get along better with others, which can lead to greater social support and less conflict, and can help you to remain feeling good even when things around you are not so great. And finally, number 10, seek professional help. A therapist can help you identify unknown triggers that are the root of your stress. Often when talking to a professional, they can assist you with your own self-awareness, and in this case, possible triggers of stress, or maybe not the positive ways that you've been managing. Professionals are also a great resource to assist with education and encouragement toward utilizing positive coping skills when it comes to managing stress. Like I said, you guys, these tips are just some of the many that you can try to implement. Leave a comment if there are any strategies that have been successful in your life when it comes to managing stress. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more of this content, and we'll catch you guys next week. Have a great rest of your Sunday.